is the fair?
November 8th to 11th, 2018, okay. Mega Trade Hall. Yeah. One and Mega Mall.
But how many products would you have, or at least how many vendors? Let's put it to vendors.
There are 100 vendors coming from 13 regions.
Okay, so 100 vendors.
Yeah, so that's Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao.
Okay, one of the criticisms of other fairs is the prices are so expensive. Somebody wrote that it's for the well-heeled, it's only for the wealthy of Manila. How do you, Marge, you can take this, how would you balance that? I mean, give me the price range and why are the prices sometimes high? Maybe you can explain.
Of course, some of these...
Ito.
Oh. This is La Herminia from Aklan.
Okay. Maganda.
Yeah. So,
silk ba ito or pinya?
It's pinya. It's pinya. Of course, you know, as opposed to other fairs, they are designers or they make special things for the fair. And they really price it higher, I think, to the people who can afford it. I think it was in Rockwell, no?
Yeah.
But this is in Mega Mall, so this is actually a different market. And we're really, the wives are absorbing the costs of the...
Ah, really?
Yeah, of shipping.
So you are subsidizing?
And, yes. Oh. Because otherwise, I mean, these are really artisans who work out of their home or out of a co-op space. So it's, they don't have the means to be able to bring their beautiful handcrafted things to the market where they can fetch a higher price.
Oh,
even the price points are also lower.
Yes,
so
a lot
I mean
lower.
Even for instance, you know, a brand like Kaayo.
Yeah. Oh, she's wearing one right now. We can show that. Yeah.
So she's created a special scarf that's also handcrafted but at a lower price point.
Specifically for the fair.
That's amazing. Do you have a sayang you don't have
I
that
don't,
right
I,
now? Because Kaayo became famous for the tangkulo,
yes,
no?
Yes,
so
exactly.
You're saying there's a special one that's really for you guys.
Yes. So you can only find it at the Kabuhayan.
Yeah, and how much would that be there? Have you priced it?
I think she priced it at between 1.5 and 2,000.
Yes. That's affordable.
Yes.
I'd have to say, because sometimes you go to other fairs, it's hitting 5 to 6,000. Huh?
And it's the same quality. Everything is handmade.
Yeah.
So it's the same quality. We also have food products.
Yeah,
so
but this one, Luli, how much would this be? Like, this is really beautiful, huh? Because it's pinya, if you accessorize it, tapos yan, may design siya here, you put the belt in.
Yes.
So the range na lang, maybe this.
I would say between 2.5 and
that would be the range.
Yes, yes,
so
yes.
Affordable talaga.
Very, very, yes.
Oh. Why did you choose to make it like that over, let's say, maybe raising more money and just having wealthier customers buy it? Why this approach?
I think for us, it's also part of our objective to be able to bring Filipino products to a wider audience. So you can't discriminate by who can afford and who can't. So it's always better to be able to present products that are well made at a price point that's affordable, and then also for the producers that they're able to gain a wider market than
Okay, I want to hold this. This looks like recycled plastic. Is that correct? Okay. Ah, Louis Bayo. Ah, ito ba yung... Hindi ito yung bayong syaga, iba pa to.
Yes, this one is a product of Quezon City.
Ay, nice.
So,
okay.
Quezon City has many different small and medium enterprises that the Vice Mayor is, Vice Mayor Joy Belmonte, who is also our member, that she's been supporting, and so they are all going to be presented in the Quezon City booth.
Yeah, because this one is recycled plastic.
Yes,
ito yung mga
yes,
zero waste.
Yes.
Para instead of throwing the plastic away, ito yung pang-wrap kasi ng kahon eh.
Yes.
Balikbayan box. And then they make it into bags. Oh, di ba?
Yeah. So a lot of it is really also livelihood projects of the women and the spouses. And it's really being more proud of what's representing your province.
Yeah. This is gorgeous. I'd have to say, I was going to say.
$450.
Oh, yeah. Guys, look at this. I was going to say, look at this very stylish clutch. 450 pesos? Oh my! How does it work when it comes to the final pricing? How much does the, let's say, how do you divide it? How much does the maker get and how much does the CSFI get from the retail?
No, what we just do is we just offer, normally in my case, I subsidize the booths for Rizal.
Okay.
So we just allow the vendors to sell it at their price.
I see.
That's why there's no middleman, there's no percentage of sales.
No, but then the CSFI doesn't get a percentage?
No.
So how will you raise money?
Well, we have generous sponsors.
I see. So I like this that we're discussing. Yours is a different business model, I'd have to say, because in most bazaars, the host of the bazaar will get a cut.
Yes.
Yeah, that's why magja-jack up ang price.
Yes.
They'll get
by
a
at
cut,
least 30%.
Then yung cut, yun ang ibibigay sa charity.
Yes.
I see. Yours is different. So continue, Luli. You got it from sponsors.
Yes. So we were able to get sponsorships from Pagcor, from
San Miguel.
PCSO, from San Miguel, from
Petron,
and from
Filipino May Puso Foundation.
Smart.
So in other words, the funds going to the fishermen, will mostly come from there.
Yes. The other thing we did was, well, although this one, as Marty said, the booths were paid for by the congressional spouses.
Okay.
So part of that goes to the payment for for Vegamall, for the space, etc. But a small part of that will also go to
CSFI.
Yes.
Okay.
To our beneficiaries.
I